नमस्ते टू ऑल स्टूडेंट प्रेजेंट हियर। माय सेल्फ साक्षी पांडे, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर वेटरनरी साइंस। एंड इन दिस सेशन वी बेसिकली टॉक अबाउट द क्वासी विटामिंस। सो एज इन प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अ लॉट ऑफ अबाउट द वाटर सोल्युबल विटामिंस, एंड इन देयर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट लाइक पैराडॉक्सिन, फॉलिक एसिड, वाइटामिन B12 एंड बायोटिन। ओके, बट इन दिस सेशन द सेशन इज बेसिकली अबाउट व्हाट योर क्वासी विटामिंस और व्हाट योर क्वासी विटामिंस यू बेसिकली deal with terms, some vitamins that are quasi in nature and what are their introduction. Okay, so this is a very specific and very brief part of your syllabus. Okay, so quasi vitamins are those which act as a vitamins, but it is something else in their chemical compounds. Okay, so those are basically what your quasi vitamins. Okay, so in simpler language you can take them from any sort of books and any sort of website structures. And basically in quasi vitamins you basically know about the quercetin, okay, and your betadine and choline. Okay, so these are the most prominent and most simplest form of quasi vitamins that you have to be studying in your syllabus. Okay, so first in this session we will basically talk about what your quercetin. Okay, so when we talk about the quercetin, the quercetin is what your quercetin is your generic term for the number of compounds including acetyl and propionyl esters. Okay, so this is what you have to remember. Quercetin is what the compound which include the acetyl and propionyl ester, and the L isomer is biologically active. Okay, so L quercetin is basically active in here. And when we talk about the biosynthesis of quercetin, so it is basically synthesized from two amino acids, that is your lysine and methionine. And for the more knowledge, I will elaborate that lysine is your what? It is your essential amino acid, and it is what your aliphatic amino acids. While on the other hand, methionine is your what? It is your sulfur containing amino acids. ठीक है? So both provide methyl groups. This is the common point between both of them. Similarity of both of them. Both provide what your methyl group that is useful for the quercetin synthesis. Okay, so when you talk about quercetin, so it is basically widely produced in many sort of your origin dietary sources. When you talk about, so there are many dietary sources. When we talk about the plants, so every kind of plant like your food, in your food it is widely distributed. Okay, basically in your when we talk about in fruits, then avocado is very rich in quercetin, cauliflower, peanut butter, and your bread, yeast. Okay, so in plant origin you can consider all of these are the richest source of quercetin. And when we talk about the animal origin food, then all of your animal origin food, basically your beef, kidney, chicken, cow milk, stick, liver, heart, and muscle, lab muscle especially. So these contain a very good amount of what? Your quercetin. Okay. So these are the basically your what? Your dietary sources from which you can obtain your quercetin. And now we will talk about the metabolism of quercetin. So metabolism is basically occurring few phases. The very first phase is your absorption. So quercetin is appeared to be absorbed across your gut and by the active transport material or by the active process that is dependent upon sodium as well as by the process diffusion process. So you must know about when we talk about the absorption. So basically there are two types of methods for the absorption in your gut. There is passive transport or passive absorption or passive process, and second one is your active process. Okay, and both this process is across in your gut, and quercetin is basically done by your active transport that is dependent upon sodium. Okay, so if sodium is not present, and sodium is there on your body, then maybe your quercetin absorption actively is not be able to done, as well as it is also absorbed by the passive diffusion, but that is dependent upon the various kinds of factor. Okay, so efficiency of absorption appeared to be very high, 53 to 87% of quercetin is likely to be absorbed in your body when you take from any sort of diet. Okay, now how the absorption is done, when the high doses are absorbed at lower efficiency, appearing in urine and very little appear in feces. Okay, so the uptake of quercetin is what? From the intestinal lumen into mucosa is rapid, and about half of that taken is isolated in that tissue. Okay, so what happened here? Like your quercetin is uptake is taken into your intestine, and from the intestine it is regulated. It is like from blood, it is exhalated in all of your tissues or all of your cell. Okay. And it is highly absorbed, so that it has very low efficiency of what excrete out. Okay, because it is highly absorbed in your body, so it doesn't excrete out in very high amount. It has very lower efficiency of excreting out from urine and feces. Okay, now we will talk about the transport of quercetin. So when the quercetin is transported, so it's relatively very slow from tissue to plasma in both the free and isolated form. Okay, so it means ki when the quercetin is present in your tissue and when it is required to your plasma, so this process is very slow. Okay, and the total plasma level of quercetin is when you talk about in adults, so it should be above your 30 to 89 μM. Okay, and with men flowing slightly greater concentration up to 15% than women. Okay, so this is, you all know why men show greater concentration, because in males generally the diet is higher than females. Okay, so when the diet is high, when the consumption is high, so it is very commonly seen in where the absorption is also high and transportation is also higher than women's. Okay, so this is the basic reason about why men have greater efficiency of greater transportation of quercetin, because they take quercetin in high amount because they have a large amount of diet as you compare with women, so they likely show the higher concentration. Okay, so quercetin is taken up against the concentration gradient and by the peripheral tissue, and most of which can synthesize it. Tissue uptake is affected by high affinity sodium dependent transporter is there, and the organic cation transporter is also related to there. Okay, so quercetin is located principally in a skeleton muscle, which contain 95% of body quercetin. The quercetin concentration of skeleton muscle are typically 70 folds of that plasma. Okay, and plus the skeleton muscle quercetin concentration in healthy adult must be 11 to 52 millimole per mg non-collagen protein. Okay, so men and women both show comparable concentration. Okay, now we will talk about the excretion. So we have seen excretion rate is slightly low of quercetin. Okay, so it's relatively slow, and the turnover increase subsequently by the exercise. And when you exercise more and more and your muscles is used, then the concentration is somehow increases. Okay, so turnover time of quercetin in human tissue must be estimated to the 8 days in skeleton muscle and your 11 hours to your heart, kidney and lung. Okay, so excretion, the whole body turnover, if we estimate the whole body turnover, how much time quercetin take to excrete out, so it's required when we talk about the whole body, then 66 days is estimated for the whole body turnover, and this indicating the significant reutilization of quercetin among the various tissue of body. Okay, so exercise appear to produce your mobilization of free quercetin in your cells, okay, and towards the fatty acid ester of quercetin in the your muscle. Okay, so when we talk about the excretion, so you know that excretion takes place by the urine or in feces. These are the only two methods that the nutrient is excreted out from the body. So a small amount of quercetin is normally found in the urine, even the subject with low plasma quercetin concentration also. Okay, because the urine contains somehow quercetin normally. Okay, naturally urine contains some kind of quercetin. If the person's body is very lack in quercetin, still they contain some sort of quercetin in urine. Okay, some of this may come from the renal secretion of quercetin, either in a free form or a short chain fatty acids. So there are some condition also that leads to the accumulation of quercetin. Okay, so that when you take a supplement dietary choline, so these are like when you're having an overdose of quercetin, it get also accumulated in your body. Now we will talk about the metabolic function. So what are the kinds of function that may involve in your quercetin? Okay, so quercetin, what they do, it function in transport of long chain fatty acids from cytosol to mitochondrial matrix for oxidation as a source of energy. So as you all know that fat is like fat, 1 gram of fat provide 9 kilocalories. It is a basic source of energy. It is an abundant source of energy. But that energy is oxidized and that energy should be negotiated from the fatty acids. Okay. So this fatty acid undergoes some sort of chemical reaction, some sort of catabolism or metabolism reaction. Okay, so generally known as beta oxidation of fatty acid. So beta oxidation of fatty acid requires the molecule of quercetin. Without the quercetin, the transportation of fatty acid cannot take place. And if it's not takes place, then the source of energy is not produced in our body. Okay. So this is a very, very important function of what? Your quercetin. So you must understand it in likewise way, like fat is required for the source of energy, but only fat can oxidize in mitochondrial matrix. So to transport it from mitochondrial matrix, quercetin is basically required. The molecule of quercetin required, and without quercetin molecule or in the absence of quercetin, the long chain of fatty acid cannot be transported, so the oxidation of energy cannot be takes place. Okay, so the mitochondrial inner membrane is your impermeable to the long chain fatty acids. So therefore, the dependent on quercetin ester is there, so that it can enter in your mitochondria. Okay, so this is your mitochondrial layer, and it is impermeable. It means the fatty acid chain cannot be permeable or cannot be enter inside that mitochondrial layer. So quercetin molecule is what? It brings down, it makes that door for the long chain of fatty acids so that they can enter in mitochondria. Okay, so this is a very important function of what? Your quercetin. Other than this also transport the process. Okay, it affects the two trans esterification in one, the fatty acid ester of CoA and quercetin and three mitochondrial enzymes also. Okay, now the enzymes which are involved in its function is very first enzyme is your quercetin trans acyl transferase. Okay, second is your quercetin acyl transferase second and acyl quercetin transferase. Okay, so these all enzymes help for the hydrolysis of fatty acids and its ester. Okay, so these are the important function. Other than this, we can also say that quercetin is released and returned to the other side of membrane, and thus the free fatty acids or beta oxidation of fatty acid can be stored in mitochondrial matrix that I already explained you earlier also. So other than this, the under condition of when you take acid urea, okay, acid urea is what? It is a condition when your urine became very acidic in nature. Okay, it is generally occur with the deficiency of vitamin B12 and urinary excretion also. But there is some sort of quercetin is also there which can improve this condition. So if quercetin is not there, then the condition is became worsen and the person is became more susceptible or more prominent to the acidouria, severe acidouria. Okay, so what its deficiency generally brings to a person? So very first thing is muscle quercetin deficiency. Okay, your muscle is became very deficient in quercetin. Primary systematic quercetin deficiency. Okay, it involves the transport of skeletal muscle as we have discussed earlier. So if quercetin is not there, then your skeletal muscle is become what? It became weak, it became fragile and very porous and very tend to break. Okay, so your muscles is very became weakened at that time. Other than that, you can also experience several kinds of features, clinical features like metabolic encephalopathy, okay, cardiomyopathy, hypoglycemia, okay, hepatosteresis. So these all are what your clinical features. Okay, so what they mean? encephalopathy when your brain is not actively participate in particular function or particular action. Cardiomyopathy means, cardio means your heart muscle when not takes place, when not work properly, it's not pumping
or not pumping the blood properly, and hypoglycemia,
or no, when your glucose level is come down, okay, so blood sugar level is became reduced in your blood. And the several other things are also, hyperammonemia is also there. It what, when the amount of anemia is can be increases in your blood. Okay, now the health effect, so is basically affects a person muscle, its plasma, show the lipid accumulation, and with the high risk of encephalopathy, weakness and muscular cardiomyopathy. Okay, and in plant and in children is also very much susceptible with this problem, and it can lead to protein energy malnutrition also, because you know that fat is not oxidized, and if fat is not oxidized properly, then it became accumulated and it became, it make person obese on became its malnourished. Okay, so severe protein malnutrition is also seen in patients, or basically in infants or in children. So these are the very, very severe changes that can be happen. Other than this, if the deficiency is prominent, then it can affect the hepatic function also. Hepatic function is what? Your liver function. So it reduces the functioning of liver. Thus, patient became more susceptible to liver cirrhosis or hepatitis or jaundice. Okay. So all your liver cells became very weak. So that's why you became very susceptible for the viral infection. Okay, so this is what happened in your, like when you became quercetin deficient. Other than this, renal function is also affect. Okay, so as you know, it normally lost in urine. Okay, almost lost in urine, and the person is became dilate. Okay, the person is became very much as you can say, it became depleted, and the loss of quercetin is there,
and normally lost in urine, so it can give person kidney cramps.
Okay, cramps is there, and person became very more susceptible for the dialysis methods. Diabetes can be also arises with its deficiency, and cardiovascular function is also affect, because it generally affects the cell wall of your what, your heart muscles. Okay, so cardiac muscle is suffer, so that's why the functioning of what, your brain, sorry, brain, so of your heart is also be suffers. Okay, so these are the possible deficiency disorder of quercetin. So I guess you're well satisfied with this session, and these are the examples of your quasi vitamins. Okay, so thank you for this session.